Hi, dear friends and subscribers of Cricket Happenings. Well, I'm going to start off with some cricket news which is coming in from the International Cricket Conference, the ICC. And let me tell you, dear friends and subscribers, that is not good news. And the news is that it's really, really rocked the cricket world, because what it has done is ICC, as you know, of late we have seen in the past, probably I would say in 2014, it all started from 2013, we had one particular player being banned. It was Johan Botha, and then he was cleared, as you remember. And then in 2014, it all started with Shane Shillingford of West Indies, and then it was followed by Sachitra Sen and IK of Sri Lanka. Then it was the turn of Kane Williamson, the part-time off-spinner from New Zealand, and also Saeed Ajmal was reported. And the reason that the cricket world has been rocked by this news is because ICC has deemed the entire bowling action of Saeed Ajmal, the wonderful Pakistani off-spin bowler, who also has also got the dusra going, and he has been banned from any bowling for Pakistan as of now. And that is the reason I said the ICC has rocked the cricketing world with this news, saying that Saeed Ajmal, the off-spinner from Pakistan, has been banned from bowling in international cricket, as ICC, after testing his action, has deemed his action to be illegal, not only on a particular delivery, but for all deliveries. We know, as far as other players were concerned, it was only a case of certain deliveries that they were, yes, but in the case of Saeed Ajmal, they feel that all the deliveries were exceeding the normal level that was required for a spinner, is the 15 degrees level, which is permitted, and probably he is going over that, was going over 15 degrees, and that's the reason he has been banned from bowling for Pakistan now. And that's that's something of a real shocker coming in for the Pakistani off-spinner Saeed Ajmal, who has been so consistent that if you look at it, he's the number one ranked bowler in ICC ODI rankings, and also figures in the top 10 in test matches and 2020 internationals. And for the last 3 years, he has been the highest wicket taker for Pakistan. And that is something which has come as some real rude news for Pakistan. And one can really talk about it. I will do some analysis later. But also telling you, that we also had other players who were suspected, and there was Prosper Utsaya who undergo testing. Then we had Sohag Ghazi being sent from Bangladesh to go for testing, and off-spinners have been totally on focus in the year 2014 especially. And we know that Kane Williamson was banned again. That was something like, but Kane Williamson, we can say he's a part-time off-spinner, but Saeed Ajmal is the heart and soul of this Pakistani cricket team, and especially considering that the World Cup 2015 is coming up, and also considering that there is a very big tour that Pakistan is undergoing now, and they are going to be playing Australia in the United Arab Emirates. It has come as some real shocking news. But that is what it is. They have deemed the action illegal. In fact, the whole bowling action has been deemed illegal. Because this is the biomechanics experts are the ones who actually tested him at the National Centre here in Brisbane in Australia, and they are deemed the action illegal. Now, as far as Saeed Ajmal is concerned, Saeed Ajmal has taken it in his stride. He has been very cool, and he has mentioned something here. He says that basically he had an injury. There was an accident that happened, and that accident was the reason that is bowling. He had a medical condition. He had the natural bend in his arm because of an accident. And Saeed Ajmal has decided that he's going to appeal to the is going to appeal to the ICC's bowling review group and see what comes of it. And one only hopes that Saeed Ajmal, the off-spinner, is really, really, they take this into account, and I only say that saner counsel prevails as and when the decision is taken, because as I said, for Pakistan, he is the heart and soul as far as the bowling is concerned for Pakistan, and he not being there in the World Cup 2015 in Australia and New Zealand would be a big, big blow for Pakistan to their chances in the World Cup. But I wish him good luck. He has been a wonderful bowler to watch. He has been really, really mesmerizing the all the opposition batsmen. Every opposition batsman has great respect for Saeed Ajmal, but now he definitely has a crisis on hand. And the only thing that I would like to say is, Saeed Ajmal, we are all with you. You do your appeal, and let's fight it out and see what comes of it. Because I think if Saeed Ajmal is not there, Pakistan would be robbed of some great entertainment value, because he is such a wonderful cricketer. He always, always contributes for Pakistan, whether it be with a bad ball or in the field. So I can only wish good luck for Saeed Ajmal. But only thing is, what really, really is surprising for me is that the off-spinners have been in focus, there's no doubt about that. But suddenly this news coming in, I'm sure Saeed Ajmal's bowling action has been seen by all the experts and they would have tested him. Suddenly this news has really, really come as a great shocker to the cricketing world, with right-arm off-spinner from Pakistan, Saeed Ajmal, being banned from any further bowling until further notice. So one only hopes that he reviews it and, you know, vice versa prevails and he gets his verdict in his favor. Well, I can only wish good luck to Saeed Ajmal. As I said, the Pakistan team, according to me, is incomplete without such a versatile off-spinner like Saeed Ajmal. Well, so from here, I'm taking you down to the fifth day's play, and there is nothing to really talk, because I just want to come up with the news that West Indies have already wrapped up the first test match here at Kingstown in Hounsvale before the lunchtime. In 1 hour's time, they have actually completed the proceedings here by winning the match by 10 wickets. Yesterday, as I told you, Bangladesh and West Indies, in the sense Bangladesh had 46 runs in arrears, and the important pair for them was their captain Mushfiqur Rahim and Nasir Hussain. But today, well, Mushfiqur definitely got alive early on in the innings today when he actually pushed the ball outside the off stump to Jerome Taylor, and the ball was actually going to first slip. But unfortunately, it was in the air and it actually sped towards the boundary. Nasir Hussain was there at the crease along with Mushfiqur Rahim. Nasir Hussain, well, he couldn't contribute much. As I said, it was very important that Nasir Hussain had to contribute, but unfortunately, that was not the case. And it was a real procession, in the sense, from after doing all the hard work yesterday, fighting it out hard, this Bangladeshi team found it pretty difficult, as the first wicket to go today was Nasir Hussain, as he got a ball which was a short delivery. He actually tried to pull that delivery, and that edge went to Shannon Gabriel, who from mid-on, the ball actually got top-edged and went into the air, and Shannon Gabriel made no mistake. So Nasir Hussain was the first to go, caught Gabriel, bowled by Kemal Roach for 19, 3 fours, and after that, just talking about what happened, it was a real procession, as Mushfiqur Rahim on the other end was really, really fighting it out. And once Nasir Hussain went, Mushfiqur Rahim realized that the only way that he could do something where Bangladesh could actually be in the lead, and also Mushfiqur Rahim also could go to his personal milestone of a century, is to really get on to the attacking mode. And that's what he precisely did when he actually went after Jerome Taylor to hit him for three boundaries in a single over. those shots, in fact, one was a cut shot which went away for four, and then a half volley outside the off stump was screened through the cover region for a boundary, and the other one and the final delivery, which was actually angling down towards Mushfiqur Rahim's pads, was gently clipped behind the fine leg boundary for a four. So three boundaries, and then what Mushfiqur Rahim was doing was absolutely right, because the very next over, it was Kemar Roche getting the debutant all-rounder Shaugat Ahom LBW. It was a plump LBW. In fact, he went for a review, but well, it went in favor of Kemar Roche. So Shaugat Ahom was gone. LBW bowled Roche for a duck, and Mushfiqur Rahim was still there at the crease, and Bangladesh still were in arrears at that time with a score on 291 for 7. Tajul Islam was the next to go, as he was there for a for he faced 7 balls, and then there was a real a sort of a snorter delivery coming in from Shannon Gabriel, the pace bowler. It was outside the leg stump, but in trying to actually keep the ball away, Tajul Islam what happened was he actually got the ball. He tried to actually defend that, but the ball actually went on to hit the stumps behind his legs, and he was gone for a duck. And in the same over, Shannon Gabriel got a fuller delivery to Rubel Hussain, and it was pretty quick for Rubel Hussain, and he saw his stumps going for a walk, and then the score read 292 for 9. And now the situation was such that whether Mushfiqur Rahim, who was batting on 94, could get a century in the company of the last man who had come up, but Mushfiqur Rahim, well, what a way to actually bring up his century. Mushfiqur Rahim slogging Kemar Roche for a century. This was his third test century, and what a knock that was. Excellent batting. It was absolutely excellent batting. In fact, Mushfiqur Rahim, after playing 4 deliveries, realized that now is the time for him to attempt a big one. He actually cleared his front leg and put Kemar Roche into the over the fence for a 6. What a shot that was, and what a way for Mushfiqur Rahim. It shows a lot of guts in this person, and the Bangladeshi captain Mushfiqur Rahim bringing on his century in style, and that was his third test century. So it was a lone battle that Mushfiqur Rahim was raging against the West Indies. Al-Amin Hussain, after that, I'm sure Mushfiqur Rahim would have been relieved, but Mushfiqur Rahim, as you know, he's such a determined player. As Bangladesh, as I said, the score was, after that 6 was hit by Mushfiqur Rahim, the score was, the Bangladesh score was 298 for 9. But now Mushfiqur Rahim had done one job, which is for his own betterment, but there was one more job which was remaining to be done. And what Mushfiqur Rahim did, after he got good company from Al-Amin Hussain, who actually played made an over, he hit Roche for a boundary, and then after that, after probably another 4 or 5 overs, Mushfiqur Rahim tried to get one more boundary, and finally Mushfiqur Rahim was doing his job. Al-Amin Hussain was there, so that was a good part. He had played 12 balls without any runs to his name. But finally, Mushfiqur Rahim had to go. But what the one good thing that Mushfiqur Rahim did is not only did he get a century, but also ensured that Bangladesh won't be suffering an innings defeat. And when Mushfiqur Rahim was out for 116, caught by a Bravo on the leg side at square leg, it was all over. As Mushfiqur Rahim was out for 116. With 15 fours and 1 6, and that was the end of the West Indies, end of the Bangladeshi second innings. So, but as I said, the good thing that Mushfiqur Rahim did is he actually saw to it that Bangladesh won't be suffering an humiliating innings defeat, and he definitely put Bangladesh into the lead with that knock. But unfortunately for Mushfiqur Rahim, who raged a lone battle today, Bangladesh were all out for 314, thus giving West Indies a mere formality to complete of 13 runs for victory. Let's have a look at the bowling figures today. It was Kemar Roche who picked up the wickets, 22 overs, 6 maiden, 64 runs and 4 wickets. Shannon Gabriel chipped in with 17 overs, 9 maidens, 25 runs and 2 wickets. Jerome Taylor, 17.3 overs, 3 maiden, 64 runs and 1 wicket. Jermaine Blackwood, who didn't bowl today, there were no spinners seen in action today. It was all the handwork of the pace bowlers who really, really wrapped it up as the new ball was fairly new early in the morning today. The new ball did the job for the West Indies. And as far as the mere formality was concerned, West Indies required 13 runs for victory, which they knocked off in 2.4 overs. Chris Gayle was not out on 9, the 2-4. Brathwaite was not out on 4, and that was the end. And it was the player of the match went to crack Brathwaite. Now Brathwaite, as you know, got his maiden double century, so he was given the man of the match, and he richly, richly deserved so. And what a victory. So West Indies in this two test series against Bangladesh are one up now, with the second test going to be beginning at Gros Islet, I reckon, and that would be played probably next week. Just wanting to see if the second test is going to be in Bissau. We call it the Gros Islet, where the match is going to be played. Well, as far as this particular match is concerned, now for Bangladesh, what one has seen is that the second innings they showed a lot of pluck, but in the first innings they couldn't do that. I think the bowling is the one which is, even though Tajul Islam was the only bowler who actually bowled well, but Bangladesh have a lot of spade work to do. In fact, they have to go back and see how they can do their fielding, because I thought the fielding was the one which cost them a lot, because the West Indies ran on to a huge score. Just because of the shoddy fielding of the Bangladeshi fielders, because they dropped catches, a lot of catches were dropped, and Bangladesh has to really, really perk up things when the second test starts at Bissau. Well, dear fans and subscribers, on this very, very sad note, cricket has been the cricket world today has been really, really shocked by the news that Saeed Ajmal of Pakistan, their ace bowler, the ace Pakistani off-spin bowler from Pakistan, Saeed Ajmal, has been banned from bowling in international cricket till further notice by the ICC. After all his actions, after his entire bowling action was deemed illegal by the ICC. Well, I can only wish good luck to Saeed Ajmal. And I'm sure there are a lot of fans in Pakistan and around the world as far as Saeed Ajmal is concerned, and we can only wish that Saeed Ajmal definitely everything goes well, and finally by the grace of God one would be seeing Saeed Ajmal in full color in the 2015 World Cup in Australia and New Zealand. But one more thing is that, as you know, in October, as I said, Pakistan are taking on Australia. One does not know whether by that time, if things could be ironed out, that would be great for Saeed Ajmal. I would love to see Saeed Ajmal bowl against Australia in the United Arab Emirates. Well, United Arab Emirates, there are pitches which definitely aid the spinners. Well, dear fans and subscribers, on this very note, I'm going to conclude my cricket afternoon show for today. Hope you all enjoyed it. But again, on a very sad note, this cricket afternoon show is to end. And that is because of Saeed Ajmal being banned from international cricket by the ICC. Thanks for your company, and thanks for regularly watching Cricket Happenings. Your host, Ram, will see you tomorrow. Thank you.